Today we have a good one, guys. You know, when I do my sit down talks, we gotta pull out the tea. So I hope you have your tea also, because we gotta talk. Basically, I wanted to do like a fun little sit down video. It's not really that fun. It's supposed to, you know, bring awareness to certain issues that us Black girls have to go through. And you know, I don't think it's right for me to just not talk about these things, because I want to be inclusive for everyone when the world isn't inclusive. So that's that. I feel like I shouldn't have to say this, but I'm going to say it. This video is not made to offend anyone. It's easy to get offended when you talk about race, because it can be a touchy subject. So this is not to shame anybody, because I know we all have our own struggles, and this is just my personal experience because it's the life that I live. So I can't speak for everyone. So yeah, this intro is probably hella long. So let's get into it. The first thing that I want to address is people not understanding how long it takes to get ready. At least for me. You guys see my hair videos. Like, it takes me forever to do my hair. Doing your hair is an all-day process. Me getting ready, I don't know if it's just me, but it takes me so long. And I know they always joke about like Black people being late. I feel like 90% of that has to do with hair. Another thing is like me, from like 3rd grade to 11th grade, I was in a white school district, and basically I can make a whole nother video on that. It's something that I don't really talk about much, but it did shape me. It does shape who I am and all this other stuff. So I can make a whole nother video on growing up in a white school district as a Black girl, as a Black person in general, because it's hard. Side note, growing up in a white school, they just expect, like, if there's another Black person, a Black guy or whatever, they're like, oh, you guys look so cute together, you guys should dance, like, no. Like, just because his skin color matched mine don't mean we go together. And they used to do that all the time. Like, they loved, like, picking out this one Black girl with another Black guy and matching them. Like, they used to play matchmaker. They started Black People Meet, to be honest. Like, okay, so another thing. My hair has always been pretty long, so often it don't matter who it is, people always ask me if my hair is real. Why? Oh, here's another thing. They'd be like, oh, are you mixed with something, because your hair looks really good? Why must I need to be mixed for my hair to look nice? I had this one kid literally on the school bus come to me, touch my hair. One, that's another problem. It's like, I don't know where your hands have been. Don't do that. This one kid, this big boy, came up to me and was like, just touch my hair. He was like, your hair is not real, right? I was like, yes, it is. He was like, no, it's not. No, it's not. Black girls don't have long hair. I was like, no, this little piece of I felt like I had something to prove. I had to literally pull on my hair to prove a point that my hair was real. That's problematic. Just because I like to wear extensions, wigs, doesn't mean I don't like my hair. Sometimes I just don't want to do my hair. That's why I'll do other styles. Well, I didn't realize how much I needed to do this until I actually did it. So this one really is more serious, and it kind of gets me upset, is the fact that Black girls are always shamed for acting a certain way or doing a certain thing. And excuse me, let me just pause here. For the sake of this video, I'm gonna be talking about Black Americans, okay? Black people from America. Where I'm getting at is, like, let's say a Black girl's mad, she has an attitude. She, right then and there, is considered an angry Black woman. She's mad, this and that. You can't talk to her, you can't be with her because she's always angry. A Black girl does it, it's problematic. It's bad. Like, I don't understand. All right, the next thing is going to sleepovers, or if you sleep in with your boyfriends, your men, and it's nighttime and you know what's got to come out, the mushwa, the bonnet, it's got to come out, or we're gonna wake up looking crazy tomorrow. It does kill the mood, I'm not even gonna lie. All right, so this one, I feel like every Black girl goes through this, like changing your hair regularly and people commenting on it. I take pride. I change my hair so much and I love it. One day my hair will be like this, the next day I have on a short bob with bangs. Like, another thing is people, teachers in particular, anyone that works in a school district, not knowing how to pronounce my name. Now let me say this, I know my name is not easy to pronounce, but I've had somebody call me cereal before. Cereal, like a box of somebody called me cereal. Why? It was to the point where whenever we had a substitute teacher, the whole class would say my name for them. before I even said it. All right, another thing is when you grow up in a white school, there's only like 1 to 2 black people in the class, or you're the only black person in the class, they expect you to know all the black history answers. Just as I know your history, you should know my history too. Or like if we're talking about black issues, or slavery, I always feel like I need to defend my people. I always feel like I need to defend myself. And I always just felt so freaking awkward in those classes whenever we talk about those things. I remember in one of my classes, we were learning about Africa. Mind you, none of these people been to Africa before. I promise you that professor or teacher never been to Africa. There's one racist kid in my class, and he's been racist since I first moved to that school. This kid's been an issue. But during class, he screams, "Oh, African booty scratcher." I will never forget that. Sometimes I just wish you can go back in time. But yeah, and then other people started laughing. And I'm just like, that's funny. And he made some other remarks like, oh, everyone in Africa is poor, hungry, dirty. Like, they doing better than you. I'm confused. Which Africa are you talking about? All right, another thing. This is more of like a serious topic. Not really. It is serious. But it's just the way that black women are portrayed in the media. One of these magazine companies, they always have black women with no clothes on. As if black women's bodies is the only thing that's marketable. And then also with the TV shows, I feel like that's why a lot of people who never met black people before have this certain perception that all black people act the same, all black people do this, all black people do that. It's because of how the media portrays black women and black men. These shows are entertaining, like I do love basketball wise, but like we need to do better. Another thing, and this is crazy because it's mainly black people doing this to other black people, but it's being pushed in a box for being black. They expect all black people to do the same thing, be the same way, and if you don't, you're exiled from the black community, you lose your black card. So it's like, you're not accepted by white people. And then next, you're not accepted by your own people. So I hate that about black culture in general. Like, black culture is so many different things. What really opened my eyes to this was listening to a documentary in one of my black study classes, and it was about Afropunk. We all have that playlist where it's not just rap songs. Like, come on. Like, being black is not just one thing, and I hate that black people shun away other black people who may be different or who may not like the same things. Like, black people are so quick to judge other black people if they don't do things that are meant to be black. But yeah, like, growing up, I definitely felt that. The next topic is being called an Oreo or being called white. One big lesson I've learned growing up, never change for anybody. Stay who you are, no matter what. Like, because people just try to do whatever they feel is cool at the moment. I've gotten told from other black people, oh, you're white, you act white. And today, I don't give a fuck. Like, I'm like, okay, that's your opinion. One thing I've heard somebody tell me before, oh, you're so pretty for a black girl. Thank you? Is that what I'm supposed to say? I don't understand. What does that mean? All right, another thing is being expected to know how to dance, being expected to know to be really good at sports. Oh my gosh, I cannot. Okay, and the last thing, it's black men saying that they don't date black women. I understand we have preferences. I never understood if you don't want to be stuck with somebody who looks like you. Like, that just shows how much self-hatred you have toward yourself. Why are you saying you don't like a race? You could say, I don't like girls who do this. They get hurt by one black girl, and now they're talking about,
I don't want to date no black girls.
I just ignore them. Who wants to be with somebody like that anyway? Like, I'm like, good, because no black girl deserves to be with you. And honestly, let me get real talk real quick. I feel like after that person said that to me, when I was little, that started kind of my self-hate towards myself, because it made me feel like being a black girl, there was something wrong. So I feel like that's the real problem here. It's self-hatred. If you have self-love towards yourself, like, you're not gonna say things like that, to be honest. My tea is done, and so is this video. Well, yeah, that's just some of the struggles that I just quickly wrote down to discuss with you guys today. Growing up in white America, these are things that I will have to deal with, because I can't go home and take off my black skin. My black skin is here forever and I love it. Although there's struggles, I wouldn't change it for anything. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Make sure that you hit subscribe, and it don't matter what color you are, comment down below what struggles you go through as a girl, whoever, boy. It don't matter. Don't leave me no nasty comments, okay? Because I didn't make this up. I didn't do this to myself. And make sure to leave your comments down below, because I'm curious. And I love just relating to you guys. And this is very therapeutic. So if something happened to you based upon your skin color, don't be afraid to speak about it. I will see you guys in the next video. Bye. But I was just like, that's not nice. You're in it too.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, I'm putting that in there.
No, don't do that. Down, yeah. I've been feeling so, I've been feeling so.